Imagine waking up to the shocking news that your favorite singer, the legendary Elvis Presley, has passed away. It's a devastating blow, but as time passes, some people start to question if everything is as it seems. This video will dive into the intriguing and sometimes disturbing theories surrounding Elvis' death, exploring the suspects and the possible motives that have left many fans with more questions than answers. Elvis Presley, the king of rock and roll, was an iconic figure whose impact on music and popular culture is undeniable. His sudden death on August 16, 1977, left a nation in grief and sparked a curiosity that continues to this day. While the official cause of death was ruled as cardiac arrest, a result of his declining health and prescription drug abuse, some individuals couldn't help but wonder if there was more to the story. When it comes to investigating a person's death, one often looks at those closest to them. In the case of Elvis, that brings us to his inner circle, a group of individuals who were constantly by his side. This crew included Colonel Tom Parker, Elvis' longtime manager, and his loyal bodyguards Lamar Fike and Sonny West. These men were like family, but as we delve deeper, we uncover a complex web of relationships and potential motives. Colonel Parker, a mysterious figure in his own right, has long been a subject of intrigue. He was known for his shrewd business tactics and an unwavering focus on making Elvis a global phenomenon. However, as the years went by, Elvis' health deteriorated and his ability to perform consistently was affected. This led to tour cancellations and a decline in Parker's income. Some conspiracy theorists suggest that Parker, facing mounting gambling debts, saw Elvis' declining health as a threat to his financial stability. With the formation of Boxcar Enterprises, a merchandising company, Parker could potentially make more money by exploiting Elvis' image rather than relying on the singer's live performances. This theory proposes that Parker, in an act of desperation, may have seen Elvis as a liability and considered extreme measures to ensure his own financial gain. Joe Esposito, Elvis' close friend and one of his most trusted employees, seems like an unlikely suspect. He was the best man at Elvis' wedding and had been by his side for years. However, appearances can be deceiving. Esposito, like many others, had his own grievances with Elvis. He was involved in a lawsuit against the singer over a failed real estate venture, and the constant concert cancellations due to Elvis' health issues added to his frustration. Theorists argue that Esposito, being personally close to both Elvis and Colonel Parker, could have been influenced or even manipulated into participating in a murder plot. His story, which changed during the investigation, only added fuel to the fire. Could he have been covering up for the true murderer, or was he an active participant? The questions remain. The Stanley brothers, David, Ricky, and Billy, were often seen around Elvis, but their role was often exaggerated. They were portrayed as essential members of Elvis' entourage, but in reality, they were more like assistants or errand boys. Despite this, they had access to Elvis' private space and his medication, which raises some eyebrows. With their love for drugs and the glamorous lifestyle that came with being around Elvis, some believe the Stanley brothers had a motive to keep Elvis alive. However, their close relationship with Vernon Presley, Elvis' father and their mother, makes them unlikely suspects. Yet, David Stanley, with his martial arts skills and a temper, cannot be completely ruled out. Let's explore a hypothetical scenario based on these theories. On the fateful night of August 15, 1977, Elvis, his daughter Lisa Marie, and his girlfriend Ginger Alden left Graceland for a dentist appointment. Joe Esposito, with his access to the mansion, could have used this opportunity to slip an undetectable poison into Elvis' water glass, knowing his habit of taking pills nightly. As Elvis returned, unaware of the deadly cocktail awaiting him, he indulged in his usual routine, unknowingly consuming the poison. The result? A death that appeared natural, caused by cardiac arrest, just as the murderers had planned. This theory suggests a well-coordinated effort between Colonel Parker and Joe Esposito, utilizing their knowledge of Elvis habits and their access to his medications. While these theories present a chilling narrative, it's essential to examine the motives and opportunities of the suspected individuals. Colonel Parker, with his financial troubles, had a clear motive, but did he have the heart to carry out such a plan? Joe Esposito, although frustrated with Elvis, was a loyal friend and employee. The Stanley brothers, despite their grievances, seemed to benefit more from Elvis' presence than his absence. Furthermore, the idea of these individuals, especially Joe Esposito, being capable of such a heinous act goes against their character as portrayed by those who knew them. Many who worked closely with Elvis describe a tight-knit family-like atmosphere, making it hard to believe that such betrayal could occur within their ranks. As intriguing as these theories are, it's important to remember that they are just that, theories. The official investigation into Elvis Presley's death concluded that it was a result of his deteriorating health and prescription drug abuse. While some questions may remain unanswered, the evidence points towards a tragic end to a legendary life. Elvis Presley's impact on music and popular culture is undeniable, and his sudden death left a void that cannot be filled. Whether it was a natural tragedy or a carefully planned murder, one thing is certain: the world will forever remember the King of Rock and Roll and the mysteries that surround his untimely demise.